Good evening, and welcome to the 129th commencement exercises for Port Townsend High School. Tonight, we join with you to celebrate in the accomplishments of the graduating class of 2019. To begin our program, I would like to thank those who have worked to help make tonight a success for our seniors, including families, especially parents and grandparents, friends, community, and school faculty who are here in the audience. I'd also like to recognize our school board members here tonight, Laura Tucker, Connie Welch, and Keith White, as well as our superintendent, Dr. John Palm. Thanks to all of you for joining in this celebration. And now, please welcome our ASB President, Julianne Short, and Class President, Story Walsh.
Good evening to the faculty, family members, friends, and of course, the students. I am Jules Short, and I've had the opportunity to be the president of our class for the past 3 years and of the student body for the past year. It has been a long ride. We've spent the last 12 years working toward this penultimate goal, and it's finally here. Some of you may be sad, remembering days gone by, reminiscing on moments with friends, and looking back on these essential formative years of our lives. However, we need to remember now is a time to celebrate. As we look back, we need to think of the very best times, feel proud of how hard we worked, feel grateful for the friends we've picked up along the way, feel love for everyone who has supported us through this journey, and most importantly, feel excited for what the future has in store.
My name is Story Walsh, and I'm the class president. This is my first year in the leadership role for our class, and my second at PTHS. Our class consists of artists, singers, athletes, scholars, actors, and so much more. In most other high schools, this would not be considered an impressive feat, but we are no ordinary high school.
You can see by the array of colors and medals decorating the students up here that most of them are a part of something. It is unique that we have such a high level of involvement in such a variety of activities and that students feel comfortable taking part in what they love to do. It is even more remarkable when considering that we are the smallest graduating class in over a decade.
Most of all, our class defies the idea that bigger is better and proves that size doesn't matter. Since we were freshmen, we were surrounded by larger classes. The graduating class of 2016 was 82. The next was 88, and last year was 87. Our class has a solid 69. Our journey was long, hard, and sometimes a little bit painful, but in the end, very gratifying. It's time to get excited for this next stage in our lives. One of the most important things we can do for ourselves in this monumental moment of our life is to decide right now, without hesitation, to commit to the adventure that's in store and not to the outcome. It doesn't matter if our dreams come true if we spend our whole lives sleeping.
So, make mistakes and realize that they're what make life interesting. A life oriented toward discovery and passion is infinitely more rewarding than a life oriented toward not screwing up. Live life for the journey and not for the destination.
We thank you for being here tonight and welcome you. For this is the class of 2019.
Each year in June, we gather here at McCurdy Pavilion to celebrate the achievements and success of our PTHS graduates. While graduation is a time of reflection for some, we see it as a time for these young men and women to look ahead into their futures and imagine all the wonderful things that lie ahead for them. In July 2008, we were shocked and saddened to learn of the untimely passing of our 2008 graduate, Andy Palmer. And here, less than 2 months after Andy himself walked across this very stage for commencement, we all gathered again as members of school, family, community, and others came together to mourn his passing and to celebrate the special person Andy was. The Andy Palmer Memorial Scholarship was then established to honor a graduating senior who consistently exemplifies the personal characteristics as practiced by Andy Palmer during his life and his efforts at encouraging a culture of kindness, loyalty, integrity, and humility. Tonight, I am pleased to introduce this year's scholarship recipient to you. This award is maintained and supervised by the Port Townsend High School Scholarship Foundation. Our football team donates the entrance gate proceeds from one of their home games to match the scholarship amount awarded by the foundation, which doubles the total award for this recipient. This scholarship has a unique application process. It is not awarded based on the traditional scholarship process which our seniors follow. The Andy Palmer Memorial Scholarships invite individuals to nominate deserving seniors based on those qualities by which Andy lived his own life: kindness, loyalty, integrity, and humility. Please join me in recognizing this year's recipient of the Andy Palmer Memorial Scholarship, Jason Kuntz. And now, please welcome our superintendent, Dr. John Palm.
Greetings. For those of you who are following the program, it made me think about the 34 commencements I've been to, and not including my own. And when I was thinking about that, I thought, how many of the speeches of a superintendent do I recall? And not even the ones I gave, I can't recall what I said. So I just wanted to speak from the heart just briefly, though. Congratulations. I've gotten to know a few of you in the class of 2019. Great group of people. I'm really heartened because as I get closer and closer to retirement, I know you're going to keep Social Security solvent for us, so we appreciate that. That's right. But I do really appreciate being here in Port Townsend and part of this team. I really want to call out the educators here today that have been a part of these students' lives from, you know, preschool all the way through their senior year here in Port Townsend, and even if you came from another community. The time and effort and commitment that that these folks put in is really amazing. And as I've been somewhat removed over in a district office, I get to see, you know, you come early and stay late, and there's always teachers and other staff in the building really working hard to make your experience the best it can be. So I want to just ask you to just applaud for those staff members who are made things special for you. And lastly, I know there's several people that put this together today. It's a huge event. It's awesome to see so many people here celebrating. But last night, we had a school board meeting, and our school board member, Nathaniel O'Hara, actually kind of spoke from the heart, and I think it was really meaningful. He's unable to be here tonight with us, but he said that life is short, and really take time to hug those you love, and what better time to do that but on graduation night. So thank you, and welcome.
The honors of valedictorian and salutatorian are the highest academic awards presented by the high school. Individuals selected for these honors not only have the highest GPAs in their class, but have also demonstrated excellence within academic rigorous coursework. Please join me in congratulating these outstanding seniors. The valedictorian for the class of 2019, Raphael Bacon. and salutatorian Annika Carlson. And now please welcome valedictorian Raphael Bacon.
Excuse me. Good evening. Fort Townsend School District Board members, Superintendent Palm, Principal Earhart, Fort Townsend High School faculty and staff, family members, friends, and fellow graduates. At the beginning of the year, Mr. Dow told our class there are multiple components to the human brain, including a logical and an emotional component. So I asked my father about this, given that he has a PhD in neuroscience. After 30 minutes or so, I was confident I had made the correct decision not to major in neuroscience in college. Whether or not there is a biological basis for either a logical or emotional brain is not critical. What matters is to understand that individuals have personal biases to interpret the world, and everything they do is subject to these biases. A few weeks ago, Principal Earhart informed me I would be given the opportunity to speak at graduation. So I immediately began to research speech topics, and my personal bias to find and accumulate data led me to learn the following. There are approximately 37,000 high schools graduating more than 3 million students this month. If on average each student brought four family members and two friends, along with faculty, 15 million people would be listening to 5 speeches tonight. Each speech will be approximately 5 minutes long and contain roughly 800 words. And typically, there will be 2 bad jokes per speech. Valedictorians will talk about a variety of topics, but most consistently, after thanking their parents, friends, teachers, principals, and support staff, they will settle in and rely on the most common speech element, the use of the well-developed cliché. Clichés, clichés, clichés. Be the change you wish to see in the world. Today is not the end of your education, but only the beginning. Follow your passion. Okay, you get it. Valedictorians seem to have a skill for reaching for the stars in search of well-refined, sophisticated speeches suitable for studying by future generations, but in reality, they'll use clichés which are suitable for Hallmark. But what is the alternative? Should I expand on the bleakness of the human condition? For after graduation, is it our destiny to end up on a personal island following the Lord of the Flies book to see logic and reason destroyed by the wickedness and impulses of people around us? For me and a few others, Lord of the Flies was a very difficult read, especially when Ralph's optimism and sense of right was defeated by the evilness of the self-indulgent Jack. Is this what we're supposed to learn about the world? As of dealing with dating and acne and driving lessons and working at McDonald's isn't enough? Now you're telling us any sense of progress or accomplishment is going to get shattered by evil at first opportunity? Of course not. English would get better. There will be uplifting prose, inspirational rhetoric, calls to a greater good. It was to be in Shakespeare, of course, with his play Hamlet. Are you familiar with Hamlet? Here's a quick synopsis. King dies. King's brother marries queen. Young prince vows revenge against his uncle. King's ghost appears to prince and reveals king was murdered by his brother. Prince pretends to be insane. King's brother laces the prince's drink with poison, but the queen dies after she drinks from the cup instead. Prince kills his uncle in a sword fight, but he subsequently dies after being cut by his uncle's poison swordship during the fight. Huh? Are these the lessons of the life to be learned in high school? How am I supposed to stand here today and cheer on our efforts to graduate, only to know my classmates and I face a life filled with sorrow, deception, and tragedy. trying to find a summer job wasn't already challenging enough. No wonder the typical speech often turns into a cliché-riddled mess. The challenge inherent in such a speech is obvious. What injustice can a typical privileged high school senior speak to? What worldly insight can a senior provide? What topic would an 18-year-old senior be able to expand upon with deep insight and understanding? Exactly. Speaking for myself, I can't do that. But here's what I can speak to in this age of my life, is small victories. Classmates working together to understand challenging literature. Classmates debating world problems during Mall United Nations. Classmates practicing together to perform during school musicals. Classmates bowing together are on athletic fields or doing mock trial or knowledge bowl. Classmates standing together to protest the lack of climate change action. Classmates supporting each other in each of our endeavors. This is not Lord of the Flies. This is a series of small victories which have prepared us to take on the larger challenges that await. We have been confronted with tasks and given objectives designed to enrich us, to build our confidence, to grow as individuals, and to achieve success. The values of Port Townsend, community, place, support, creativity, excellence, and diversity, are reflected in the goals of the Port Townsend School District and implemented by the incredible teachers we have been fortunate to have over the years, dating all the way back to elementary school. All of us have benefited from growing up in this extraordinary community which believes in these values and of being educated in a school system which challenges us without crushing us. Now, I'm currently over 800 words, so I should wrap up with one last quote from a children's literature book. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who will decide where to go. We've worked hard to make it to the stage tonight. Our emotions are naturally all over the place, excited, joyful, bittersweet, or even sad. But we should take pride in our efforts, be thankful of those who supported us, and remember that whatever the future holds for us, we will be forever linked by our time spent together here in Port Townsend. Congratulations to my fellow students, the Port Townsend High School class of 2019. Thank you. And now it is my pleasure to introduce... And now it is my pleasure to introduce salutatorian Annika Carlson. And now it is my pleasure to introduce salutatorian Annika Carlson.
That's a tough act to follow, I'll be honest. Okay, hello, my name is Annika Carlson. To all my friends and family, visitors from afar and the larger community, thank you all for coming. I am honored to be up here speaking in front of you tonight. Congratulations to the parents in the audience. We wouldn't be standing up here without you. Thank you to all of our teachers, school faculty, coaches, and mentors who have helped to shape us into the students and humans we are today. And most importantly, congratulations to the class of 2019. We've made it. When I was younger, I thought I had all the answers. I knew who I was and what I wanted for the most part. But the questions were simple ones with easy answers. I was sure I liked chocolate ice cream better than vanilla and that I wanted a mermaid-themed birthday party. And I wasn't afraid to let people know what I liked or what I wanted. However, as we've gone through the years, the questions have gotten more complex and that surety has slowly faded away. Now the questions sound like, what are your plans after high school and how is that going to set you up for the rest of your life? Those aren't questions that most of us can answer in a heartbeat. And for me, someone who always likes to have the answers, not knowing how to respond was a rude awakening. I felt like I didn't know anything about myself anymore. How could I not know what I wanted to do? I was so consumed by the fear of making the wrong choices and messing up that I would rather have stayed home and avoided important decisions altogether. On one particular day, when I was obsessing over my top two college choices, I decided to watch a short TED Talk by Brené Brown called The Call to Courage. Some of you might have heard of it, in hopes that it would give me some clarity. She spoke about a quote by Teddy Roosevelt that encouraged her to take risks without worrying about what other people might think. This passage, The Man in the Arena, goes, "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat." I did not make my college decision that night, but his sentiment stayed with me and influenced my final decision. I knew then that I couldn't make my choice because I wanted to look good to other people or was afraid to let them down. I also knew that I could not let the fear of failing stop me from taking risks. I was watching my life from the sidelines, and I didn't want to live that way. Now it is our time to step into the arena. One of the most courageous things a person can do is be their authentic self. Most people struggle with this all their life. Growing up in Port Townsend, we have a little bit of an advantage. Our whole lives, people have encouraged us to embrace our individuality and told us not to try to be like everybody else. Teenagers here aren't afraid to dress how they like, love who they love, or pursue a non-traditional career path. Because Port Townsend High School is so small, it's easy to look at all the opportunities it couldn't give us. I know I've been guilty of this. However, it is inarguable that being raised in PT gave us the ability to be who we want to be, something for which I'll forever be grateful. Regardless of what you thought when you were 9, it is true that we don't have all the answers. But that's all right. Part of the great adventure of the rest of our lives is searching for those answers. And maybe we will never find some of them. Others we will think we know and end up failing miserably. But falling sometimes is how you know that you're pushing yourself. As Robert F. Kennedy said, only those who dare to fail greatly can achieve greatly. As I go forward, I keep telling myself, and I urge the rest of you to do the same, that when you find yourself at a crossroads, choose the scary option. Forget the critics and naysayers. Don't let anyone else hold you back from doing what you truly want to do. And whatever it is that you do want to do, don't just take part in it, do it unabashedly. Do it with fire and passion, because we are the generation that is going to make a difference and save the world. Yeah. I'll conclude by encouraging you, my friends and peers, to live your life in the arena, and know that if you do, I'll be standing right next to you, cheering you on. Thank you. And now I am pleased to introduce faculty speaker Ben Mattern.
I'm a little sick, so bear with me. Thank you everyone for coming tonight to celebrate and support the Port Townsend Class of 2019. And a special thank you to the Port Townsend High School faculty for nominating me to speak tonight. I know that I, along with the rest of my fellow classmates, really appreciate everything you have done for not only us, but the rest of the high school. All of you have impacted our lives and helped us become better people. I need to raise that up. I know for a fact that if I was the same kid as I was in middle school, I probably wouldn't be up here talking right now. Like many of you out there in the audience or on stage, I spent a portion of my middle school experience in the Blue Heron office with a lunch detention. I'll never forget the disappointment in my mother's eyes after I told her I got a detention for blasting Sal Khan's video at 50% speed during math class. The result was that it sounded a little too much like he was teaching us how to find slope intercept form after pounding one too many brewskis with his boys. You know how those math guys get down, right, Mr. Freeman? I was acting out long before I was in middle school, however. Back in kindergarten and elementary school, I was a bold kid, regularly pushing my boundaries, and all the while I was trying to figure out who I was and the things that I enjoyed. I went through my phases of trains, then dinosaurs, and of course Pokemon. But there was a phase that spanned throughout all my childhood, and that was the superhero phase. Unlike most of my peers, I wasn't trying to be Spider-Man or Superman or even Batman. Instead, I created my own superhero, Naked Man. Now, fair warning, Naked Man wasn't actually naked. He did wear a cape and I would say a rather stylish pair of Lightning McQueen tidy whities. Like any good superhero, Naked Man aimed to serve and protect the world from evil at all costs, including at times my parents' sleep schedule. I would have the time of my life running around the house, way past my bedtime, screaming at the top of my lungs. Eventually, I grew tired of this routine, so to my family's delight, Naked Man began making appearances at other households instead. I think it speaks volumes about the city of Port Townsend that I would show up to people's houses wearing just a cape and underwear and nobody would even bat an eye. People are usually pretty accepting of toddlers when they do something like that, but to let a legit second grader do it, mad props to all you PT parents. Instead of calling CPS, y'all let Naked Man do his thing, so respect. As the legend of Naked Man grew, unfortunately, so did his age. Eventually, the seemingly unforeseen future in which Naked Man had to hang up the old cape and undies, in fact, became a reality. Last Tuesday was really tough. Although Naked Man may be gone now, I think it's important we make sure he's never forgotten. We all need to be comfortable in our own skin, both figuratively and literally, just as he was. Oftentimes, as teenagers and young adults, people try to put us in a box and tell us who we are or who we should be. With so many external influences, it's easy to lose sight of our values and hone in on what is truly important to us. Growing up in an age where technology and social media dominates our teenage lives, we find ourselves chasing an inhuman and flawed standard of perfection. I know that I've fallen victim to this warped reality. I found myself missing out on experiences with friends and family because I didn't feel comfortable with the way I looked that day. I found myself going places or doing things that I didn't really enjoy just because I wanted to fit in and seem cool. I got so caught up with my public perception, I forgot about my own values and what truly makes me happy. It took me until only recently to realize that ultimately, the only voice we should listen to is our own, and sometimes our parents. That was for my mom. As I began to reflect upon what truly makes me happy, and there was plenty of time to, because literally every single college essay asks you to, it became clear to me how I lost sight of what mattered most. I realized how much I cared about kindness, integrity, humor, and an overall enthusiasm for life. Ironically, these very values epitomized what Naked Man was all about. The more I thought, the more I realized how fortunate I already was. The class of 2019 embody all of these characteristics. I'm so thankful to have been part of such an amazing group of individuals. Although we might not all hang out together 24/7, I've been all around all of you long enough to recognize how special every single person is. I know the bonds and friendships I've created will last a lifetime. Soon, the journey that we've been on together for the past few years will end. We'll go our separate ways and start the next phase in our adult lives. Some of us will continue school, some will travel, some will work. Each of us has a unique path in our future because we're all different people. The only way we can do what's right is by listening to ourselves. My only advice to all of you is grab yourself a cape, maybe a pair of Lightning McQueen underwear, and do what makes you happy, all while saving the world. Thank you. And now, please welcome a senior tribute from the one and only Mr. Ben Dow.
The Marvel Universe has come to an end with many a shed tear. Jaden cried more at Endgame than he got concussions this year. With a superhero vacuum, I imagine the PT Avengers could fill in the gap. Isaiah's super flow could cut down bad guys with rap. Abel will get zapped by his own invention and be able to run at light speed. Forget Batman's utility belt. Zach's fanny pack has everything real heroes need. Chase can annihilate defensive lines with a sweep of his arm, and Nikki will always protect the defenseless from harm. Logan's designed a souped-up Batmobile to get the PT Avengers tricked out, and Aaliyah, with her trusty sidekick Janelle, any duel is a rout. Jamie and Margot, are they super friends or arch enemies? None of us know, but more drama, please. Bodhi could practically produce the PT Venger soundtrack alone. You can hear him in the booth shouting, "Elena, more trombone!" Cole can envision a second act that's a real tour de force. ABBA and Carly C are happy as long as they each get their own flying horse. Hannah's the changer of worlds, the carbon neutral queen. Skye's super team power is to never be mean. If she needs strong words, though, Eli's got the persuasive power to put on the hurt. Lord of Memes Keegan has his own catchphrase, "Skirt, skirt!" Kuba flew in to defend truth, justice, and the Polish way. Sarah R. can paint everybody Marvel-themed shoes so they look sharp, saving the day. Barrett and Mia could team up to unleash their twin flower power. Peyton's that superhero who swoops in at the very last hour. Monica the magnanimous will always fight to defend those who need a win. Nico's superpower is definitely his infinite grin. If Jacob gets to film, the B-movie action will be nonstop. Taryn will play any part as long as her theme's pure K-pop. Some folks miss the movie because they were in class. Carly K, Jason, and Tao were all down at the college hoping to pass. Leanna, Chris, and Jonathan did some running start too. Tiger even found time to give her own mom a tattoo. Keith spent hours with Rainbow Six's Thermite and Habana. Sarah C just wants to get back to her beachside cabana. Eileen, Story, Ashley, and Vigo did senior projects with kids, pets, and the aged. Kalei, Tegan, Haley, and Aiden had projects so big they deserved to get paid. Sasha and Nora both pursued their artistic dreams. Henry and Gabe's lightning speed helped lead our Knowledge Bowl team. Yeah, Knowledge Bowl. Kyle would play basketball until the hour was late. Riker's the quietest guy, but he destroys in debates. Serena's handiwork turned boat building into an art. Anyone who knows AJ knows she leads with her heart. Rosalind's so tough, it was like she walks through life without fear. And guess what? Cody finally took his hood off this year. Olivia parachuted in, and quickly she proved she could do anything. Emil did too, and somehow he even ended up prom king. As they head to their futures, there are still many unanswered questions. Will Ethan and Randy ever end their D&D session? Will Sarah still bring food to her brother, or is starvation his fate? Or will Jewel's brother ever live down her taking first place at Knowledge Bowl State? Will Hannah be taking photos of horses or out riding a few? Will Ben get one line in this poem, or possibly two? Will Brenna still be having so much fun with dead crustaceans? Will Raphael be counting down the 1,461 days till his next graduation? Will Daniel and Asa's streak of wearing matching shirts survive? Will Annika be in charge of the New York Times by 2025? Can Owen convince us the gooey duck mascot isn't the worst? And most importantly, did Ian or I have these glasses first? And so, like all aging superheroes, it's time for this class to hang up their capes. They've made it out of high school with just a few close escapes. They'll make occasional cameos in PT no matter where they might roam. Heck, Ben will be back to ask me to put him in next year's class poem. So, as 2019's final credits roll across the big screen, don't worry, the class of 2020 is ready for their post-credits scene. Thank you. And now a musical performance by Mr. Bodie LaBrie.
And now, please welcome class speaker, Ian Kilgard.
Oh my God, those were all such good performances. The bar's like up here and I'm like 5'7", that's not good. Thanks for that, Mom and Dad. I don't know if you can all tell or not, but I get really nervous when I have to speak in front of people. I mean, I'm probably sweating more than Jamie right now, and even she's gonna tell you that's an accomplishment. I would take off this glorified bathrobe, but it's doing a pretty good job of covering up all of my tattoos. But seriously, no amount of Google Slides presentations in the Dow's classes could have prepared me for this moment. Through freshman year, when I had to speak in front of the class, I would usually just pretend that everyone was naked. This system worked really well for me until I got to Mr. Gamble. Despite my ill relationship with public speaking, I still got here on this stage today. So did we all. We faced many challenges along the way. We were the first class who required an extra 2.5 credits to graduate. For more on that topic, check out my SoundCloud. We survived the school nearly being burned down when Carly tried to microwave her lasagna with a whole sheet of tinfoil on it. We also emerged shaken but unscathed from the invasion of a wayward algebra teacher our freshman year. On top of all that, we made it through state test after state test, each one bearing new challenges and questions such as, is this one a graduation requirement? What is this one going to be on? And is this one it? Is this the test that will finally kill me? The verdict is still out on whether or not we will survive the great epidemic of juuling that has plagued the halls of Port Townsend High School. Aside from all that, we've also made some good memories and had a lot of fun. I always laugh every time I remember one day at lunch when we were having hot dogs, or web dogs, as some of us call them, and somebody hid a couple of the gray boiled hot dogs in the salad bar, and then leaving school later that day and seeing Coach Webb pull the hot dogs out of the salad, stricken with confusion. Mr. Gamble, I want you to know that personally some of my best memories are of your English class my sophomore year. You passed on so much infinite wisdom to us that I even kept a list of your quotes throughout the years. These include, but are not limited to, the shape of a pretzel is, I can't draw a pretzel. Corn is exciting, but not that exciting. Shut up, Gamble. And finally, maybe you shouldn't be keeping a list of my quotes. In all seriousness, thank you, Mr. Gamble, for inspiring me to pursue a career in education and for being a generally awesome human. Please accept my Facebook friend request. Speaking of Gamble's class, I'm sure we all remember the great Mr. Busey and the day we crusaded around the school with our ruler swords, wreaking havoc on every floor of the main building. While most of us got to experience the teachings of Busey, only a few of us got to have Miss McMather. In fact, we're the last class to graduate from Port Townsend to have taken a class with GMAC. That is to say, no future graduating classes will have experienced the horrors of sentence diagramming. Besides that, I think all that took her class would agree that Miss McMather was an amazing teacher, and we all hope she's enjoying her retirement. Memories aside, I think the future is bright for most of us. Some of us are going to college where we'll work really hard, Annika, succeed, make a lot of money, Teo, and maybe, just maybe, change the world for a little bit and make it a little bit better. Looking at you, Hannah Bales. Others of us are going to join the workforce or work our way up the food chain at our current jobs, and that's okay, because some of us are still figuring it out. Whatever it is that we decide to do as we walk off the stage tonight, wherever we go, and whatever paths we take, I want each of us to remember something, and that is the importance of family. Families are not exclusive to the one you are assigned at birth. In my experience, it is possible to become a part of other families or expand what you already consider to be your own. Most of you know her as Miss Lisa, but I know her as my other mom. I think almost all of us have felt Lisa's kindness throughout high school. Lisa, thank you for not being just another adult I could count on, but another parent. You're the best non-biological other mom a kid could ask for. As someone who joined the high school after homeschooling until freshman year, I did not have many friends. I knew some of the people in my grade, but I hadn't grown up with them the way they all had each other. In some ways, it felt like I was outside looking in on a really big family. Fast forward to now, you guys chose me, of all people, to be class speaker, and I want you guys, my classmates, to know that it is really an honor that you guys would choose me to speak on your behalf on this special day. I think that really shows how your family can grow, because that's what we are. Less of a really small class and more of a really big family. These last 4 years, we've taken care of each other, worked together, laughed, cried, mostly at the beginning of every math test. It is sad to think that this is the last time our big, largely dysfunctional family is going to be together, but the memories that we have made will last forever. Before I go, I want to make a few more thank yous that I didn't get to. Thank you to my biological family, mom, dad, and all my siblings. I'd never trade you guys for the world, and I wouldn't have made any of my achievements without you. Thank you to Ben and Cowdy, my two bosses at Hanazono. You've both made such a positive impact in my life by giving me my first job and being great role models. And finally, thank you to my two best friends, Aiden and Tiger. I don't know how I would have survived these last 4 years without you guys. DJ Synonym Roll, out.
We've planned to take a moment to recognize various people. The first are this year's foreign exchange students. They are Kuba Kroll from Poland, Emil Makala from Finland, and Olivia Demius from Malaysia. The next group of students are those individuals who have been enrolled in Port Townsend School District since kindergarten. Would you please stand? Thank you. Among those in the audience, we know that there are parents and grandparents of tonight's graduates. Would those parents and grandparents please rise to be recognized? Some of our students are not the first members of their family to graduate from Port Townsend High School. Please stand if your parents graduated from PTHS. Please remain standing if your parents and grandparents graduated from Port Townsend High School. And finally, please remain standing if your parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents graduated from PTHS. Thank you. On Wednesday, we had our annual end-of-year awards program. The medallions you see several students wearing represent their identification as the top students selected by faculty in specific subject areas. These students are, for mathematics, Zach Dempsey. For science, Raphael Bacon. In social studies, Julianne Short. In English, Annika Carlson. For world languages, Raphael Bacon. In media studies, Jacob Miner. For music, Jason Koontz. In art, Taryn Rogers. For yearbook, Barrett Schultz. And in woodworking, Sarah Rogers. Would students who have earned the College and Career Ready Medallion of Academic Excellence please stand? These students have performed at the highest level on the Washington State Smarter Balanced Assessment in both English and mathematics. Thank you. I would now like to recognize members of the National Honor Society. Would you please rise? Members of the National Honor Society have demonstrated excellence in leadership, scholarship, service, and character. Thank you. Would the members of the Interact Club please rise? Sponsored by the Rotary Club, these members participate in both local and worldwide projects. Thank you. Would the participants of Drama Club please rise? You've entertained us with your wit, characterizations, theatrical abilities, and vocal expressions. Thank you. Would students who are members of our Yearbook Club please rise? We appreciate your dedication and countless hours involved in putting together our yearbook each year. Thank you. Would the members of Key Club please rise? Key Club was established in 1925 and is the oldest service program for high school students. It is a student-led organization whose goal is to encourage leadership through serving others. Thank you. Would students who have served as a Red Hawk mentor please rise? Your dedication to the culture of our school and community and genuine concern for the welfare of others is admirable. Your leadership and enthusiasm has been wonderful. Thank you. Students wearing green stoles are recipients of the ASB President's Award as selected by our ASB President, Jules Short. Would you please rise? These students have been chosen for their strengths in leadership and school spirit. Thank you. Students wearing burgundy stoles have participated in mock trial. Would you please rise? These competitions began in 1987. Port Townsend has had teams compete in 27 of the 30 years that this program has been in existence. Mock trial allows students to participate in true-to-life courtroom drama before real judges in real courtrooms, gaining an understanding of the law and judiciary procedure. Thank you. Students wearing white stoles have participated in our advanced culinary arts program. Would you please stand? These students have volunteered many hours to prepare food for catered events in our community. Thank you. Students wearing purple stoles have participated in Knowledge Bowl. Would you please rise? These students have consistently competed and placed at state-level tournaments. Please remain standing if you are a member of the 2019 State Championship Team for PTHS. Congratulations and thank you. For many of our students, their high school experience extends beyond the confines of our campus. Please stand if you have traveled to Europe with the Visit History Club, participated in the Youth Environmental Stewardship Program, or have participated in any travel associated with our high school, including the Maritime Program. Thank you. Additionally, we have had students from PTHS who supplement their high school coursework through various programs. Please stand if you have completed any coursework through the West Sound Tech Skills Center, the district's Ocean Alternative Program, or Running Start. Thank you. Student leadership is a vital part of high school life. Students wearing red stoles have served as a senior class officer during their senior year. Would you please rise? Thank you. Students wearing black stoles have served as an executive officer on our ASB council during their senior year. Would you please rise? Thank you. Please stand if you have been involved in the Associated Student Body for all 4 years of high school. Thank you. In addition to the medallions and stoles, several students wearing gold honors cords are graduating with a cumulative grade point average of 3.33 and above. Would you please stand? Thank you. Many PTHS students excel in the areas of academics. Please stand if you have earned an academic letter for maintaining a 3.8 GPA or higher for 5 or more semesters at the high school. Thank you. Several students are involved in our school in a variety of ways. Would students who have participated in after-school activities and clubs please stand? Please remain standing if you have competed in state, national, or international level competitions with these activities. Thank you. Would students who have participated in athletics at Port Townsend High School please stand? Please remain standing if you have lettered in one or more varsity sports. Remain standing if you have lettered in a varsity sport for all 4 years of high school. And finally, please stand if you have participated in state-level athletic competitions for Port Townsend High School anytime in the last 4 years. Thank you. If you have been selected to play on an athletic team at the collegiate level, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Port Townsend High School is rich in tradition. On the walls of our gymnasium are names of student athletes who have made their mark in history. If you have broken a state, league, or school record in your sport, please stand. Thank you. We have many seniors who have demonstrated talents in the musical and performing arts through their participation in our school band, orchestra, or theater productions. Would these students please rise? Thank you. Please stand if you have taken one or more advanced placement courses at Port Townsend High School. Students in the AP program engage in rigorous college-level coursework. Thank you. When we think of graduation, we tend to focus on the celebration of achievements, but we often forget to recognize that some students have overcome struggle and significant obstacles to make it onto this stage tonight. In Port Townsend, with the exception of our foreign exchange students who are guests on this stage, only students who have earned their diploma make it onto this stage. And as I look at the class of 2019, you may be small in numbers, but you are mighty in courage, perseverance, and soul. Each of you walk your own individual path, and for some, I know that path has been tough. Some of you have battled homelessness. You've gone to treatment to deal with your addiction. Some of you have suffered tragedy and loss of a family member or a close friend. Some of you have had to persevere through significant medical or emotional health issues. And some of you have worked so hard to overcome learning challenges. But through those struggles, you still got out of bed and faced the day. You did your best and worked as hard as you could. You showed up to school, even though for some of you, the school system did not always flex to meet your needs. You've maintained hope, a sense of humor, and the belief that you could do it, that the diploma was worth it. So for those of you up here tonight who have walked a challenging path thus far in your life, know that we honor you, we believe in you, we celebrate you, and you are worth all the good things that life still has in store for you. So each of you have walked a unique path, but we would like to recognize three of our seniors that are the first ones in their family to receive a high school diploma. Would those students like to stand and be recognized? Thank you. It's now my pleasure to announce this year's local scholarship winners. The high school gives special thanks to the members of the Port Townsend businesses, organizations, community, and surrounding area for their generous scholarship support of our students. A comprehensive list of individual scholarships awarded by each student is included in your program. We're going to recognize them by name. Raphael Bacon, Caleb Warshed, Annika Carlson, Skyana Iardella, Teo Johnson, Jason Kuntz, Liana Kuntz, Margot Manuel, Ben Mattern. Sasha Mosier. Rosalind Salmon. Owen Scanlon. Julianne Short. And Nico Winiger. Congratulations to all of you. And now we're going to have a musical presentation from our high school orchestra. It is now my pleasure to announce the presentation of diplomas for the class of 2019. Our first set of diplomas will be presented by our board chair, Connie Welch. Bowden Emerson Labrie. Daniel Stenberg. Elijah Harding. Peyton Keenley. Lenora Lee Kingsley. Ian Rubida. Riker Wells. Vigo Wolfgang Watson. Kyle Raffel. Serena Obert Silva. Ethan Mitchell Blossom. Keith Patrick Muck. Timothy Logan Flanagan. Rosalind Emily Salmon. Teo Twain Johnston. Emil Makala. Our next row of diplomas will be presented by our school board member, Keith White. Margot Lacey Manuel. Jamie Claire Rogers. I'm just going to make him wait a little bit. Cole Christian Crawford. Isaiah Samuel Tribal. Jaden Parker Watkins. Jonathan Aaron Brown. Christopher Durham. AJ Schott. Sarah Lauren Rogers. Mia Niebel. Tiger Ray Vera. Barrett Marie Schultz. Ashley Lynn Rosser. Sasha Alicia Mosier. Matzenbacher. Our next row of diplomas will be presented by school board member Laura Tucker. Owen Christopher Scanlon. Zach Dempsey. Randy James Lawson. Keegan DeLee Nordstrom. Jacob Richard Miner. Abel Parkman Tulpin. Cody Markell. Chase Campbell. Elena Teresa McConaughey. Monica Chavez. Hannah Bales. Olivia Demius. Caleb Warshed. I also want to announce that Caleb is also earning her AA degree from Peninsula College. Sarah Lee. Our remaining diplomas will be presented by our superintendent, Dr. John Palm. Abigail Kithcart. Hannah Grace Germeau. Eileen Elise Leoso. Carly Kellogg. Nikki Massey. ZTW Gabriel Aeneas Petrick. Elizabeth Rogers. Sarah Clark. Carly Grace Casebeer. Liana Kuntz. Skyana Iardella. Aaliyah Rogers. Aaliyah. Aiden Burton Falgi. Patrick Kelgard. Henry Steyer. Raphael Bacon. Brenna Ann Franklin. Claire Marie Short. Our next graduate is also earning his AA degree from Peninsula College, Story Walsh. Carlson. Cuba Crawl. Jason Koontz. Nicholas Dean Winnegar. And Benjamin Joseph Mattern. Thank you. Would the senior class please rise? Class President Story, please turn to face your class. It is now my honor to recognize this class of 2019 for having duly satisfied the high school graduation requirements for the state of Washington, as well as for the Port Townsend School District. Congratulations.
Thank you.